It's the most recognizable aircraft in the world, a Boeing 747 jet with the iconic blue and white paint scheme and seal of the President of the United States displayed prominently on its sides. Air Force One, as it's commonly known, is a symbol of the American president and the power of that office, and has visited every continent except for Antarctica. It's currently, however, an aging plane, with it and its backup twin having been in service since 1987, quite the lifespan for a modern airplane. Now the United States finds itself in need of a new Air Force One, and even before he officially took office, now President Donald Trump famously protested the staggering price tag of $3.2 billion over Twitter for Boeing's contract to produce two replacements of the presidential plane. That single errant tweet ended up costing Boeing millions as its stock plummeted due to uncertainty over the future of a contract that had been in place since 2015. $3.2 billion is quite the sum, and for months President Trump claimed the figure was absurd and that he would get a better deal. Ultimately, he would quietly authorize the original contract with Boeing, and in fact the total sum would increase to nearly $4 billion for the two planes. But why in the world are these two planes so expensive? The first thing to consider is that the total cost of the Air Force One upgrade program is not for the planes themselves, but rather for research and development, procurement of the actual aircraft, and for all of the many high-tech systems on board. This price tag includes upgrades to just about every facet of the aircraft, and most of the money sink is not in the plane itself, but rather the multitude of extremely high-tech and classified hardware that rides inside it. A large piece of the price tag goes towards the defensive systems aboard Air Force One, meant to keep the President of the United States safe while in the air. Large jets such as the Boeing 747, that Air Force One's unique airframe is based upon, can be quite easy targets for enemy fighters, but Air Force One has many tricks up its sleeve to ward off an air attack. Firstly, a hostile interception of Air Force One is already an extremely improbable event. Its flight plan is calculated well in advance of any presidential visit, and is always designed so that friendly air assets are never far away. Typically, Air Force One's flight path will be shared with friendly nations, whom will have air assets of their own on standby in case they need to respond to an emergency and lend their assistance. Any hostile nation wishing to take a shot at the big plane will first have to get through an emergency response force of Allied fighters. If no friendly air forces are available, though, then carrier battle groups can be positioned along Air Force One's flight route in order to lend air support if needed. Given the global reach of America's Navy and Air Force, air support is never far from the president. If a hostile plane manages to avoid being intercepted, though, Air Force One has several defensive measures to protect itself. Although these measures are kept highly classified, some are well known. Others can be speculated on, and others can be guessed at from what can be seen physically on the plane's body. It is known, for instance, that Air Force One can defend itself against an attack with chaff and flares. Chaff is nothing more than highly radar-reflective material packed into a canister, which is then shot out the back of the aircraft. The canister explodes, filling the sky with radar-reflective material which can confuse any weapon system using radar to lock onto the plane. Flares, on the other hand, are designed to counter heat-seeking warheads on enemy missiles, and work by being expelled from the body of the aircraft and burning at extremely high temperatures. The missile's heat-seeking warhead then changes targets from the plane's hot engines to the brightly burning flares, exploding harmlessly away from the aircraft. Modern anti-aircraft missile systems, however, are getting smarter all the time, so too, though, are Air Force One's defenses. Missile launch warning receivers are located on the tail, and likely on the front of the plane as well, and can track missiles in flight by identifying the ultraviolet exhaust signature that the missile's rocket motor puts out. This system is already in operation in many Special Forces support aircraft, though their hefty price tag for now prevents them from being widely adopted by the rest of the US's air fleet. These high-tech trackers, though, can accurately feed targeting data to a rumored defensive measure of Air Force One, a high-energy laser, which can heat the head of an incoming missile and detonate it in flight. Air Force One is also equipped with an AN/AAQ-24 Nemesis Directional Infrared Countermeasure System, which fires flashes of concentrated infrared energy at incoming missiles in order to damage or confuse the targeting optics of a missile. This is similar to the Matador IR countermeasure system that's installed on the tail and behind all four engines, and also emits infrared pulses at incoming missiles in order to prevent an attack by heat-seeking missiles. Long rumored, but never confirmed, is a belly-mounted anti-air missile system with limited capacity to destroy incoming enemy aircraft. The aircraft is also equipped with several electronic countermeasures meant to jam or spoof enemy radar. Pulse emitters on the aircraft can either confuse enemy radar by sending back a radar pulse that either blocks the receiver outright or mirrors the return frequency, confusing the radar operator as to the true distance, size, and elevation of a target. As with most electronic warfare aircraft, Air Force One can spot jam in order to completely block out one radar frequency and completely blind a radar. Though modern radars are able to operate on multiple frequencies and thus are resistant to this technique. The plane, however, can also jam multiple frequencies at once, although the more frequencies it tries to jam, the less effective the jamming is. The plane, however, can also focus all of its power on jamming a single radar at all frequencies, although this leaves it vulnerable to other radars that it cannot respond to. Given that Air Force One is never far from friendly forces, this shouldn't be too big a concern. Another major part of the expense of Air Force One is its communication systems. The President of the United States is the head of the most powerful military force in the world and needs to be able to communicate with every single element of that military, no matter where it is in the world he's flying. Designed as a flying White House, the plane's communications gear allows the President to wage a full-blown war if need be from the air, and he can even order America's fleet of deeply submerged ballistic missile submarines to launch their nuclear weapons against an adversary. A big part of the almost $4 billion price tag is going toward upgrading communications equipment. During the September 11th attacks, President Bush remained airborne for most of the day and was in constant communication with the Pentagon and civilian leadership. On numerous occasions, however, he experienced bad connections and dropped calls, and now a big investment has been made to ensure that this never happens again. Designed to operate even in a nuclear environment, the plane is shielded against the electromagnetic pulses released by nuclear detonations. Normally, an EMP blast would destroy electronics across an area even greater than that directly affected by the nuclear explosion. Yet Air Force One is capable of withstanding such a blast and keeping the President connected to the rest of the military. A recent news report on the expense of Air Force One highlighted that the refrigerators alone cost $12 million, causing much uproar amongst the taxpayers who are footing the bill for these aircraft. Yet, as it turned out, these refrigerators cost so much because they were designed to, in essence, be the most reliable in the world, because Air Force One may need to operate for weeks at a time in case of extreme national emergency. The plane keeps 3,000 meals on board at all times, and this requires a lot of fridge space. The refrigerator must not fail, or else all that food would spoil and leave the President and his entourage with nothing to eat in case of a disaster. Another major expense of Air Force One, though, is the presence of a full-blown operating theater inside the aircraft, just in case the American President ever suffers a major health event. Rather than be treated at a local hospital, he will be rushed to Air Force One, which will immediately depart and set course for the nearest American military base or airport. While in flight, a doctor, which is always aboard the aircraft, can convert one of the meeting rooms into an operating theater and perform any number of emergency medical procedures. The new model Air Force Ones are also rumored to be equipped with telemedicine units, which would allow surgeons anywhere in the world to operate directly on the President via secure connection and using robotic appendages on the aircraft itself. New engines round out the list of upgrades to the new Air Force Ones under design by Boeing right now. These new engines offer much improved performance and have increased the range of the aircraft by almost 1,000 miles, from 6,735 nautical miles to 7,730 nautical miles. That would allow the big plane to fly almost a third of the way around the world in just a single tank of gas. Though not officially confirmed, the new Air Force Ones are believed to be capable of mid-air refueling, much like the current models are. In essence, this makes their range almost unlimited as long as a friendly tanker is available to top the big plane up. Being one of the best serviced aircraft in the world, and with engines that have to withstand reliability tests far more strenuous than normal aircraft, Air Force One is believed to be able to fly for at least a week non-stop without needing maintenance. The new engines aren't just more fuel efficient, though. They're also much greener than the current engines, which is good news because air travel is a significant source of pollution. Raw power hasn't been compromised for fuel efficiency or reduced greenhouse gas emissions, though, as the new Air Force One's speed is known to be faster than the current Air Force One, which has been recorded flying at a Mach 0.85. Just how much faster, though, is unknown, although some speculate that it'll be capable of breaking the sound barrier, which would be quite a feat for such a massive aircraft. Operating the new Air Force Ones won't come cheap, though, and there's no expected decrease in the average $200,000 per flight hour price tag that comes from flying the planes. That massive cost doesn't just come from the jet fuel, but from the inevitable maintenance and repair needed to keep these planes in tip-top shape. While the U.S. military maintains all of its aircraft in the best possible shape at all times to ensure their reliability, no single other aircraft, except for perhaps its fleet of B-2 bombers, are so well taken care of. Given that the President may need to take to the air and command the United States' military in the midst of a nuclear war, it's no surprise that so much time and money is spent on maintaining the two presidential planes. If you like this video and want to see more from the Infographics Show, then click on this video over here, or this video for more great content.